Look here. Luckily enough, it stopped, but more especially, it was lucky that Alsamora didn't slide any further.
Down the main straight they go yet again. It's still McCoy out in front, bike 72. This is fantastic to think this kid is leading an international Grand Prix here in his home country. Barry, it's a treasure that you never found. It was a reward you never got. You couldn't win the British Grand Prix.
Well, exactly that. It'd be so lovely for him to win it. But the danger man is certainly Aoki and Sir Carter. And Martinez come to that. You know, these are very experienced Grand Prix guys, especially Martinez. But you see there, look, Aoki's gaining on Garry hand over fist now. So what Garry wants to do when Aoki passes him, which he inevitably, back into Garry's bike sliding. You see, as far as I know, Aoki is on Dunlop tyres and Gary's definitely on Michelin. Now, if Aoki is on Dunlop tyres, then maybe they were harder tyre at the beginning, the harder tyre, so therefore at the beginning he has to go slower. And but at the end of the race, they have much much better endurance.
So Garry McCoy, the bike getting a little loose around the rear, and Aoki putting on pressure. Remember, Aoki really can stay where he is and win the championship, but he's a racer's racer, this guy. He would love to go out in the winning note. He takes the lead off McCoy now. Now, this is where we'll see Garry McCoy's character this time round. He's led twice, he's been passed twice. Alzamora came off. Now, can he catch and match it with Aoki?
Well, what he wants to do is just hang on to the back end of Aoki. You know, if he can get past Aoki, he doesn't want to do it. He just should stay there because it's a long race. And what he can do is give his tyres some rest.
He's not about to listen to
you. No, he's not. You know, but he must give his tyres rest because his tyres are getting hot and they're sliding and Aoki's on. So the best thing to do will be to go as slow as you can and stay up as far as to the front as you can.
I wrote off Takadomi. Don't do that because he's up in the fourth spot. So he's had a big charge in the last couple of laps. He was way back, but he's fought his way up into fourth spot. McCoy is not listening to Barry Sheene. McCoy wants to lead this and win it on every lap.
Taking the leap out of my wife's book. it'll just be interesting. If you watch their wheels, especially the wheels of McCoy's bike, when they're in the middle of a corner, just you see the slight movements on the, especially the back end of it. And the more it moves, the hotter it gets. It's a vicious circle. So just keep your eyes on the wheels, and you'll see, as far as I'm concerned, on Aoki's bike, he's having no tyre trouble whatsoever, whereas McCoy is.
23 points of difference between bike number one and bike number seven. That's how they went into the race. But he, Takadomi, to win the championships, needs really for Aoki not to finish, and that doesn't look like it at this stage. He has a big look though, and he would have seen that number seven. He knows he's there.
Well, he knows he's there, but he also knows that he only needs to finish about 12th place to win the championship. And he's a bright kid, Aoki. When you think he's one of three brothers that are equally as good as one another, it's can you imagine how mum feels?
I said down in the studio a little earlier what an amazing family they are. Doesn't matter the class, they're there. Sakata's out, mechanical problem, so bad luck for him. McCoy blasts his way down this long, long main straight again. Tucks in for the hard left-hander, very, very fast. Aoki sits right in behind him. Now watch for the rush up under brakes. There it is now, up on the inside. Out muscles and hustles McCoy. McCoy leaves his braking late and takes it back. What a great battle. What a ride from McCoy.
Oh, great, yeah. He must save his tyres for the end of the race because When he really needs them, the last four or five laps, you know, if you can baby them as much as you can, you know, when you get to the last four or five laps of the race, everybody turns it up to 100%, and that's when you really need the grip.
Takadomi's now gone past Martinez. He's up into third place. I tell you what, he's not going to give up this championship without a fight. He's up into third. There he is. Martinez right in behind him on 55.
Well, you saw what happened to Alsamora. Takadomi knows that can happen to Aoki, and the best thing to do is to push Aoki as hard as he can. But Aoki, as I said, he's a pretty bright guy, and he's going to think, look, I don't care if Takadomi wins this thing or whatever, as long as I get my 3 points.
Exactly. But you can't blame the kid for trying. I mean, Takadomi knows he's got to keep the pressure on. And have a look, Aoki had a big, big look then. This is all helping Garry McCoy because he's sailing away out in front at the moment, and he's going to lead him down this big straight again. The crowd must motivate him. He'd hear him, he'd see him. No doubt about that. Once he hears hits the main straight, they just stand up in front of us and they're hooting and hollering. Big cheer goes up now as Garry McCoy leads number one Aoki, and then it's Tokodomi, then it's Martinez as they blast their way down this main straight. Aoki's going to get the line on the inside again.
Now what's maybe going into the hairpin on the brakes.
All righty, so McCoy loses the lead yet again, and under pressure now from Tokodomi. We'll take a break, come back. Ah, oh, what about this for a ripper race? Great to be in your place, wherever you're watching us round Australia. Garry McCoy, bike number 72, sits in behind Aoki. And then it's Tokodomi now. Aoki and Tokodomi, bike 1 and 7. They're fighting for the championship. McCoy's fighting for the race. And I'll tell you what, sitting beside Barry Sheene, watching McCoy go round here, if you could get out and coach him on the bike, you'd be there.
No, I'm just worried. I just don't want him to destroy his tyres because... he's perfect, the position he is now at the moment. Not to keep, let Tokodomi go by, but stay as close as you can and give your tyres a rest, because when it comes to the end of it, the last 4 or 5 laps, you give it everything you've got and you need all the grip you can get. And if you've been sort of really, nice one up the inside there, if you've been really caning them, then you have nothing left. And that's, you know, when the thing turns around and spits you over the handlebars. So you've got to settle down. It's 15 laps to run yet. It's a long way to go. And, you know, you can't afford to... you need to save a bit.
Well, of course, he's had a season of indifference. The last few races have been terrific for him. He's qualified not as well as he would have hoped. He's raced very well, though. This crowd, he was pumped up all week for this. He was hoping for a bit of rain. He doesn't mind a wet track. But at the moment, sitting in the second, he's not listening to Barry Sheep. He's dead set not listening, but he's racing.
Yeah, where Gary's having a bit of problems, he's going into this hairpin, because once we saw him nearly bang somebody up the backside, I think it was Perugini, and the previous lap, he ran in there very, very deep and went wide, so I don't know why he's having problems there, you know, maybe either braking problems, or when he's braking, the front's sort of slipping a bit. You know, what happens, you brake as hard as you can, you lock the front, have to let the brake off again, but that corner's going to be very important, that downhill hairpin on the last lap, because with the 1-2-5s, you can guarantee it's going to end up a lot closer than this.
Anybody around Australia that wants to know the value of what this means, this 125cc Grand Prix, that big kangaroo on the top of his helmet, that's being looked at right around the world by millions of people as McCoy again throws it up the inside the left hand of it. Carney's really got Aoki under pressure, though. And so as Tokodomi sits in the third place. But Barry, that kangaroo on the helmet, I mean, that now is being seen all around the world.
Well, it is. I don't know. It's going out to over 100 countries. So you can imagine how many people are watching it. And this is the thing, you know. It's it is a really very, very good platform to advertise from, you know, providing it's going to the market you're interested in, because it's... very, very popular in all over Europe, especially.
The kid from Camden, he's really putting Aussie on the map here today at Eastern Creek. And up the inside, he flashes again. Tokodomi, bike 7, is the only man that can win the World Championship off Aoki. But if Aoki stays where he is at the moment in front of him, well, it's all over Red Rover. But McCoy, he's the meat in the sandwich.
Right, now you watch going into this hairpins if it happens. Yeah, I see. When he gets hard on the front, you see the back come off the ground a little bit and start going from left to right. And I think that's what happened before. You see what happens here, you get a situation where you think, right, I'm going to nail him on the last lap into the hairpin. Then you howl in there and the back wheel comes off the ground. And, you know, you end up tying yourself in knots.
Over the last 3 days, we've had a very strong wind blowing. That's dropped off today, thank goodness. Was giving the boys a much better time around the circuit. The crosswind was very difficult, particularly for these little bikes. And it's very steamy out here. We've had water around. McCoy again pops out of the slipstream. But will he get there? Oh, he gets close. But Darrell, just saying, it's very steamy because of the moisture coming out of the ground. They would be doing it tough.
Oh, it's definitely sticky. It's when they come around the next lap, they're getting up amongst the backmarkers now, but the little 125s, you'd have to say that virtually everybody riding in the 125 class, you know, is hot stuff. I would imagine they'll be lapping one of the wildcard guys, that's Jason van der Vliet. on a Honda. You know, he's an Australian. Can't knock him for being back where he is because these guys are all on factory bikes.
McCoy, listen to the crowd. McCoy, the crowd are watching the big screens out here around the circuit. As soon as he went up the inside, up they go, up the Aussie, they say. This is terrific stuff. Aoki riding smart for the championship. Garry McCoy's just riding his heart out.
Yeah, a little Rossi's dropped back to 8th place now and then down to 10th place. So he's obviously suffering from this. He's got a split collarbone, by the way. Now, when they come onto the start and finish straight, they go through this little squiggly bit where Alsamora fell off. And then there's sort of a double right and left-hander they're going into now. Very important corner. Now, you see this, right? This is to give us a real good idea. Say this was the last lap thing. If they come out like that, can Aoki get McCoy by the line? Let's see. Now he's slipstreaming. Let's have a look out the window here. Pretty evenly matched, so it's going to be exciting. You know, whoever gets the best run out of that corner is going to be the man.
And over the years, as you well know, we've seen in the 250 class, the 125 class, in the production class.
Oh, Takadomi and Aoki.
We've seen some unbelievably close finishes. Two here today already that were on the line.
Exactly that. You know, it's so important, those last couple of left-handers onto the main straight.
Good shots in the chopper as you get a bird's-eye view of the creek. And there they are, 1, 2 and 3. The traffic they've started to close up on now gives you an idea of the racing line and how much of the track they've got to use.
Yeah, great. It's a really good shot because it also gives you a good idea of who's quick where and who's slow where. So the best bit to be quick on, obviously, is the last third of the circuit. And so far, they all look much of a muchness on the last bit.
So it's McCoy, Takadomi now is in second place. Aoki's back to third. Martinez, the veteran, up into fourth place, still just sitting there. He's shattered him a lot. Don't know if he's got the hustle and muscle to get past him, though. He really hasn't made a move. Maybe.
Maybe
just thinking about it.
Yeah, Mr. Brainbox. He's not dropping back, is he? And he's a lot closer now than he was 3 laps ago. He's, see there, Aoki staring straight into Martinez's eyes. Not a pretty sight.
One of the great riders, a national hero at home.
Absolutely, yeah. Great bloke as well, really good guy. Now, have a look down the straight here. It's, if McCoy comes out so the last lap like that, I should be more than happy.
He'll win it from there if he could, but of course it's not the last lap. It's 19, there's 8 to go, 8 laps to go. If he's going to win it on crowd support, he's getting plenty. Takadomi now blasts his way up the inside into the main straight to the left-hander. He takes the lead. McCoy back into second place. Shuffled up in now is Aoki into third. Under brakes,
McCoy.
He comes up. Ooh, look at him fight, look at him fight.
Change of direction. What's this for a bundle of joy?
Oh.
Yeah. Look at this then.
Look at this. Takadomi takes it back.
Over the crest of the hill. Hang on a minute. This should be fun, maybe.
Oh, no, he's not.
I was going to say Garry will have him on the inside.
This is great stuff.
He's got him on the inside. No, he hasn't.
He's had a look and put plenty of pressure. Takadomi says, catch me if you can, and McCoy will come back. He is riding the race of his life at the moment. Garry McCoy in behind Takadomi, challenging for the world championship. And Martinez now up into third place. He's made a move on Aoki.
Yeah, Martinez is definitely the man to watch. You know, he's... Well, the funny thing about it is, you know, if you put this sort of race tactic of Aoki and Martinez, this is
McCoy.
Good move.
McCoy.
But you see, his run's a little bit wide there.
Yeah, you're right there. Yeah. He does lose a lot of ground, doesn't he? Takadomi comes back. You're right.
It's a very important corner, that is, as well, because you get stuck behind this lot and going into the last 3 left-handers. But there again, if you get good run through them, it's... if you put the brain power of Aoki and Martinez together, you know, sort of race tactic-wise, you've got two of the finest tacticians of the lot there.
So it's Takadomi now. Look at McCoy. McCoy's not going to throw this away. He fights back, weaving away as Takadomi, trying to shake him out of the stream. He can't, though. And McCoy hangs on. Aoki moves up one. No, I don't think he got Martinez. He tried to make a move on him. Martinez held him out. So it's still Takadomi, McCoy, Martinez, Aoki. And we'll take a break and come back. And don't you move
one
square meter, because he's done it again and he's in front. Back shortly. Oh, what a ripper. Good to have you company, Australia. Garry McCoy and Tokodomi, they've swapped places twice in that break. There are no more breaks at the end of this race. We're going to ride it out with McCoy now as he sits in second place. Aoki is in third. Then it's Martinez. The rest don't matter. And McCoy at the moment has been past Tokodomi twice and underbreaks the Japanese star has got him.
Yeah, it's so close. It's so hard to pick. I just worried about that downhill hairpin for McCoy because three or four times he's had some trouble there, and that's going to be a vitally important corner on the last lap. If he's in front coming down there on the last lap, I don't think that's a problem. But if he's behind and he's going to have a go to get past there, that's where he seems to be struggling, when he can go in whatever angle he wants. Now, look, maybe at the...
Had a rush up there the lap before.
Gotcha.
That, and underneath he's done, I think. Oh, has he?
Now watch on the change of direction. Watch this. Now watch when they swap directions.
Oh, what about that from Tokodomi? I mean, they're rubbing.
Oh, look at Tokodomi.
Yeah, he's had a big yard.
Gotcha.
And McCoy comes back. Go, you Aussie. Go, McCoy. What about this?
Oh,
and now Tokodomi has another go. They have rubbed knees, shoulders and heads. They're headbutting their way around the creek. Boy, out in front from Tokodomi. They'll have bruises all over them, these two. Behind them is Aoki and Martinez, just saying, what is happening up front? It's a battle.
Right, now look, going down into this, there's just something that Gary's having trouble with here, and I can't suss out what it is. No, not so bad that lap, but it appears that... Oh, well, that's okay. It's not worth talking about it, but just keep your eye on that corner.
He does run a bit wider coming out, though.
Yeah, well, that's only when he gets in a tangle in the middle, you know, going into it.
So Tokodomi on seven, still sitting in second place. Martinez is up into third. It's Aoki back into fourth. He's riding for the championship. If he stays where he is, he's the 96 world champion. But it's McCoy that everybody wants to win here. They will him on down the straight. Tokodomi shakes the head and blasts his way down the inside. McCoy has had big efforts through here, but look at this. The Japanese, he's got plenty of size sitting on the tank too, I'll tell you, because he's been quick down there.
Look at Martinez now, pretty close to the back of McCoy.
Aoki, Martinez sitting behind these two. I tell you what, Tokodomi, he's not short of bravery at the end of the straight.
No, he's not. He's brilliant. Coming up against another back marker now, and this could either make or break someone's day. That's Andrew Duke on the free
yep.
Australian guy.
Well, he's going to get a
shock
big
of his
shock
life.
In a minute. They'll be whizzing past his ears and knees and everywhere. Aoki sits in there riding for the championship, as I keep saying, but don't expect him to sit there. If he's got a chance of going past in the front, he'd like to beat Tokodomi, who can only do what he's doing. McCoy, he's just been sensational, Garry McCoy. He really struggled through qualifying till the last couple of minutes yesterday, bumped himself up to the front row, and has he won some hearts and support here today with a gutsy effort. This is the spot that worries
me. Yeah, it's the spot, but it's fine, that lap. You know, it's maybe just three unlucky ones that he had, but... It's still a bit of a worry, as they say. Right, now this is going to be interesting, coming up to the really important part of the circuit, and they're going to be stuck behind here. But Gary's in the best position there because he's not being held up too bad, so he should get a bit of a freer run onto the straight. A bit of a slipstream from Andrew Duke. That won't do any harm. At the end of the straight, should be in for a little bit of fun.
Andrew Duke, of course, one of the Australians riding here on the 125s. Now through they come. Look at them, three abreast. Look at this.
Martinez is the danger, yep. Man, I tell you.
Up almost into second.
Look at the lead that Tokodomi's
got. Yeah, he got plenty out of that, didn't he? Plenty out of that. Martinez all over the back of McCoy. So McCoy now is aware that that's closing in on him from behind in the shape of Martinez and Aoki.
Right, now this is where your tyres are important. There's three laps to run, and this is where you want every little bit of grip you've got, because it's all on now. Everybody's going absolutely flat as fast as you can go. So if we're going to get any slides anywhere, this is the time. Made up a lot of ground when you consider how far McCoy was behind at the hairpin, and he's right up his backside now.
This has been a great performance. Fantastic. I mean, I know the home crowd advantage must put you on, but gee whiz, he's done everything right. And any time he's made a little slip up, he's fought his way back with true grit. Great angles, aren't they? Look at this. Round the outside.
Round the outside.
What about that?
That's good.
Round the outside. he's round them up whichever way.
Now, you see, Takadomi was just going in on a tighter line to shut the door, and Garry just flipped around the outside.
McCoy, he's been up on the inside, up under brakes around the outside. Watch this again, Baz.
Right, you see, middle of the road, thing shut the door. No, Garry got him around the outside.
That's the hard way.
Right, now the important run. Now look at the slipstream. Let's look out.
Takadomi.
Right, now you see, if it's like that, then Takadomi would just get it. So, two laps to run.
We just said how brave he is at the end of the straight. McCoy's showing a lot of guts down in that area too, but Takadomi, look at the margin he's got there.
Takadomi's so quick through that left-hander because he pulls out an enormous amount.
McCoy comes back and he under brakes. Now Martinez, and Aoki hasn't given up this yet. This is a four-way battle. Watch this, with a lap to go, anybody can do this. The home crowd willing on McCoy, 72, up the inside, again he goes. Takadomi says, where is he coming from? Up the inside, round the outside, it's McCoy.
People are going bananas in the stands.
Oh, it's terrific. It's just fantastic. Anybody that hasn't been to a Grand Prix of international status, to stand here and watch an Australian lead it, I tell you what, the crowd here are just loving every second. This on its in itself has been the price of the ticket.
Just
hanging on.
Interesting to watch. See, Takadomi's just getting a little bit of a run there. Maybe if he can carry that run on, he'll get past before the next
kick. That's where he goes a bit wide, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Just gets out of shape as he comes out of that. So all that hard work, he's got to do it all over again.
No, that's not a problem. That's not a bad place to be now. Now, all he doesn't need to do is lose an enormous amount of ground through. If he can stay in the slipstream of Takadomi, you'll see the speed of the bikes down here. Yeah, slipstream. Garry just about. It's quick, that bike of Takadomi's, I tell you.
Right, they're on the last lap. This is it now. It's Takadomi out in front from McCoy. Aoki goes out wide, comes round the long way. Martin is beside him. McCoy under brakes. McCoy under brakes.
Yeah, go,
Gazzard! He's got him! McCoy under brakes has got him!
Right, now you have to keep it all together. This is the most difficult part for you. I tell you, it's horrific when you know you've got the pressure of everybody willing you to win. And you've just got to keep your head together, and it is so difficult.
Oh,
look at this,
Aoki. Under brakes, Aoki come round the corner of the long way. It's McCoy.
Look at Aoki.
What about this? Aoki hasn't given it up yet either, but it's McCoy leading Takadomi, Aoki and Martinez. Round they come. Remember, this is the last lap. Can the little kid from Camden, can he win this?
What we need now is Aoki to have a go at the inside of Takadomi on this hairpin here.
And muck him up.
And muck him up. In the most sporting way possible, of course.
Yeah, and he's done it.
Well, yeah, but Aoki's got a really good run out of it, you see.
Yeah, but McCoy's still got a bit of a buffer. That's where he goes wide. He still leads. Aoki now, can the master stroke, the man that'll take the championship, can he put it on him?
Aoki's bike is quick. Now, what? Got to watch the slipstream. Look how quick Aoki is through that. Oh, Aoki's getting a real good run out of this.
Onto the main straight. McCoy's got to hang on. Can he hang on? Aoki comes at him. McCoy leads him down on the draft. And look at McCoy.
Go, Gazzard!
Yeah! And the crowd has gone absolutely crazy. Garry McCoy got us. Ah, McCoy.
Gotcha. Fantastic.
From Australia, Garry McCoy. He rode on emotion and guts and he got it.
Great stuff.
Oh, Aoki's won the championship.
Look at that. Oh,
but I tell you what, McCoy's won their hearts. Aoki's won the championship for 1996. But Garry McCoy's won this crowd, Barry. There it is, the Australian flag. If you ever doubted the value of a win, there it is there.
Yeah, look at that. What did I say? Remember the last telecast?
Ah, Baz, you've coached him a lot. You've given him a lot of help over the years, and that must be the best moment for you to see that.
Lovely. So nice for it to all come together for it. It's nice when a plan comes together, he says.
Well, let me tell you, Barry Sheene has put a lot into this fella. Barry Sheen's had a lot to do with what's happened to Garry McCoy internationally. He stands there with the Australian flag, and Sheeney's as proud as punch.
That's so nice. I bet his mum and dad are going nuts.
Well, will he be the king of Camden? No doubt about that. It's not far from the creek. Remember, he cut a track out of a dirt track at home to get the circuit in his mind. What about that? I mean, the lead changed so many, many times, but he got it in the end. Aoki won the championship, and 4 points to him. He's a class act. But this kid, he stole everybody's heart today.
That was a fantastic race, though, wasn't it? There's your champion.
There's the world champion for 1996, carrying his national flag. What a moment for him. He's won the championship, and he's done it in fine style right through the year. He'll remember Australia and Eastern Creek, the last time he raced there and took the championship out. A lot of memories for him, and great memories for Garry McCoy.
Well, if Garry doesn't shed a tear, I can imagine. Can you imagine how good he feels?
Oh. Well, there's two riders there. Aoki. Tribute to Aoki. Stands tall in the saddle, bike number one, plate number one, world champion, and he's got that national flag.
And to do that, what you've got to bear in mind is you've just seen that race. That is how competitive the races have been all the season, and you've got to hand it to little Aoki. He's won the world championship on the trot.
They're coming back down the pit lane now. McCoy comes past our window, goes over to the Park Fermé area. Everybody in the stands clapping. All the marshals are clapping. He's gone into the garage now, and this is just a wonderful emotional packed moment. The door will come down and we'll be talking to them shortly. Don't you go anywhere. They're inside the shed. There's the young kid now. Look at the officials going over. This is a moment he won't forget. Down comes Aoki, and world champion. He's had a terrific season, Barry. He's a class act, this bloke.
He's great, you know, and he's... when we spoke to him yesterday, you know, he said, I'm trying very hard to learn English. You know, he's trying his best. Didn't speak a word of English last year, and hopefully we won't have to go through that interpreter guy. And Garry McCoy was 12th in the world championship, by the way. That, by virtue of the fact that he's stopped in just about every other race apart from the last four.
Here he comes down there. You can see all the officials lined up. That's the Park Fermé. The bikes are locked up in there immediately.
I hope they let Aoki speak, because rather than go through an interpreter, because he does speak English and he tries. If he's just allowed to speak slowly, there's Adriana, she's the sort of boss of the Italian team he rides for, and they would be so pleased.
Well, they've put a lot of faith in him, haven't they? And he's paying them back.
And I tell you what, look, there's the bike fin label on his left-hand shoulder there, and that's nice for an Australian company to do that. You know, it's good, and they're going all over the world, and that's nice.
Scuderia Alpha, here we go with a replay. Have a look at this now.
That was perfect. You see, he had enough room. He didn't need to wave around all over the circuit. Aoki did. You see, he's in the slipstream there, and he's gaining. He's pulling out the slipstream now to have a go, but there's just not enough left. If the line had been another 10, 12 feet the other way, he would have got it, but Garry knew that.
He certainly did. He knew what was there. And we'll be bringing you comments from them in a moment. Aoki set the fastest lap on the last lap. So there you go. So we're just waiting for the international crews to get organised here, and we'll bring you the interviews. Plenty of celebrations, Aoki, the world champion. And as Barry said, hopefully they'll let him,
yeah,
he does speak a bit of English.
It's the same as Tokodomi speaks some English, and we just hope they don't go through the interpreter, because he's a real funny little guy.
Okay then, with the man in third position today, Masaki Tokudome, it was a very close race. You lost the race, you lost the championship, but are you happy or not?
I'm disappointed because last lap, for sure I was thinking I can win, because my bike was very fast today, and also my riding also good, but Garry is very fast to enter the hairpin, but for sure I can pass him before close the checkered line. But in last lap I had an engine problem, because from hairpin to last corner I have lose power. I don't know what is the reason, but but was good race for last 1-5 race for me.
Okay, can you say a little bit in Japanese, please?
Barry,
I mean, struggling with his English, but he's done a good job to try and explain that. Some engine problems, he's saying.
That's great. You know, they should let the guys do that each time because it's so boring going through an interpreter. And he's trying really hard to speak English. And he's got a great, I guess he's a bit nervous in front of a camera when you're speaking a different language, but he's got a great personality.
Here we go. Second place. Just waiting for them to get into position.
Yeah, look at his face. He's great.
Here we go.
And now with the world champion, Haru Aoki, second in the race, world champion, what can you say?
No,
speaking English. とりあえず確実にポイントを取ることを途中考えて、途中4番手にずっとキープしててね。で、そしたらまあ最後にチャンスがあったんで、まあ2位になれてすごい嬉しいです。
It was a hard race between the four riders, but he thought the fourth place would be enough, but in the last lap he had the chance to be in front of Tokudomi and Martinez, so he got finished second and very glad to have that result.
Thank you. Congratulations. Thank you.
So there we go. The man has won the world champion and not dicing with his English. And the next interview will be the man we want to hear from, Garry McCoy. Just waiting to bring him over. Here we go. Garry McCoy.
And the winner then, Garry McCoy, winning at home for the last race of the season. It's a little bit like a dream come true, no?
Yeah, well, it is a dream come true. And I was really hoping that would have happened, you know, the way it did. But it was a tough race. I mean, it was pretty close. There was a fair bit of fighting out there, and it wasn't that easy. So definitely made me, you know, working pretty hard, and I come through. So it was great.
Thank you. Congratulations.
There he is, Garry McCoy, the winner here of the final race at Eastern Creek, the Australian 125cc Championship. We'll take a break, come back. Hey, have we got some racing for you here at the Creek.
On 60 Minutes, finally, Pauline Hanson.
Just because you're an Aboriginal is a weak excuse.
The woman who's divided a nation.
Why are you making me out to look as if I'm a racist? I won't cop that.
Who she really is.
I didn't come into this job as a polished politician.
What she really wants.
Don't drag in.
For the first time, the story everyone's talking about.
You've got to be cruel to be kind.
Also derailed the Indian Pacific, $1 billion in debt and near the end of the line. Toyota presents 60 Minutes tonight.
This is not a toothbrush. This is a plaque remover. The new Braun Oral-B Ultra Plaque Remover. Unlike a toothbrush, it has a unique cup-shaped head so plaque can't hide along the gums. Its high-speed oscillating motion is clinically proven to remove more plaque than an ordinary manual toothbrush. So you can brush with a toothbrush, or you can more thoroughly remove plaque. Ask your dentist. The new Braun Oral-B Ultra Plaque Remover.
Come to the party and celebrate Diners Club's 40th anniversary in Australia. Become a member or introduce a friend and you could win the stylish new Audi A4 Avant Quattro or one of five luxury Hayman Island holidays for two. And every new member receives a special Diners Club anniversary gift, such as Ansett Australia frequent flyer points, for the card that gives you convenience, service and great gifts. Join Diners Club today.
New Kodak Advantix. It's a whole new kind of film and camera. A film so advanced it loads in a second. And a camera that gives you the choice of three picture sizes to let you capture every moment the way you want. Like this, or this, or even this. So your pictures can be the best you've ever taken. See the new Kodak Advantix film and cameras at your nearest photo outlet. Kodak Advantix. Take pictures further.
No holds barred, it's made against mate when state plays state.
The feeling is mutual.
It's civil, but it's war.
4-6-4.
It's friendly, not. What a great shot.
The feel is mutual.
See the Victorian Bush Rangers clash with the Tasmanian Tigers in the Mercantile Mutual Cup, Sunday, October 27th at Optus Oval. Tickets at the gate.
The feel is mutual. Mercantile Mutual Cup.
If it only saves you once a year, it's a good year.
At your dealer now.
The new Braun RLB Ultra Plaque Remover. Its high-speed oscillating head is proven to remove more plaque than a manual toothbrush. So you can brush with a toothbrush or more thoroughly remove plaque with the new Braun RLB Ultra Plaque Remover.
Welcome back live to Eastern Creek, and the crowd jam-packed around the podium area here. You see the Australian flag flying high, the two Japanese flags there side by side. Aoki taking out the championship. There's the man that won, though, Garry McCoy. Now, there's a lot of trophies being presented today because this is the last International Grand Prix. Rossi gets Rookie of the Year, I just heard then.
Well, yeah, he should do as well. You know, 17-year-old kid, first time in a world championship. He's won a Grand Prix, and you couldn't ask for a better result than that, could you? You know, it's great for Aoki to win the championship again. Poor old Tukudome obviously had some problems, but even had he won the race, he still wouldn't have won the championship. And you can see old Gazza get
here. We go. You'll get him.
Rev
here we
up.
Go. Let her go. And the crowd just said they're all thronged around. They've learned over the years they've got away. Tukudome gives it to Aoki the best way he can. It comes back. McCoy says, I'll keep out of this. I want to keep something to drink. And he says, I'll do a bit of that now. And that would taste the sweetest champagne he's ever, ever tasted, let me tell you.
I tell you, when your adrenaline's up like that, does it ever go to your head?
So there we are, Garry McCoy. He's won the first race here at Eastern Creek of international status, the 125 Grand Prix Aoki, world champion. The acknowledgement there for Aoki. It's a terrific season for him to finish for the championship, but what a way for Garry McCoy to finish the season. He'll light up a lot of weeks after this, thinking about when do I get back on the bike next year. Kenny, what a start.
Yes, it certainly got the old blood going. Even AJ here, a normally cool, calm, collected sort of guy, we were really pumped for him, weren't you?
It was fantastic. I mean, the whole studio in here, we were just screaming and yelling, and I thought he'd blown it because I thought, oh, don't lead on the last lap because he'll tow past you, but he just got that brake coming out and it was able to get to the line. Fantastic.
Don't you love determination, though? You just never give up.
Hey, how good was that? Hey, if the other races are anywhere near as good as that, we're in for a ripper afternoon.
Oh, look at this. I mean, Gary's just right in his home territory here and he's soaking it all up, not just the champagne but all the atmosphere, and I guess he's got his family all around him. This is a wonderful moment for him. The boy from Camden who recreated the track on the property there, an old dirt track, and he ran around in his motorbike through the week, so he had it firmly in his mind what the job he had to do when he got here to the creek, and he did it so very, very well here today. We're all very proud of him, and that's a terrific result here, and of course we've got two terrific races still to come. The 250cc race promises to be a real dogfight for the championship with just 1 point separating the front runners. We'll meet the contenders and preview that battle right after the break.